वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. चिल्ड्रन वी हैव फिनिश्ड विथ लेसन नंबर 1 एंड लेसन नंबर 2. टुडे विल बिगिन विथ लेसन नंबर 3. द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज डाइवर्सिटी इन लिविंग थिंग्स एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशन. ओके, सो जस्ट टेक आउट page number 18 of the textbook and be ready with the pencil. Children, first of all, let us recall which are the spheres of our earth. Do the living things exist? You all have heard about spheres of our earth? Yes. What are they, children? Yes. There are 3 spheres of our earth. Lithosphere, atmosphere, and hydrosphere. Yes, children? Basically, there are 3 spheres of our earth. Lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Children, what do you all understand by the term lithosphere? Yes, land. Then atmosphere, air, and hydrosphere means water. Okay, children? So just tell me now, in which spheres of our earth do living things exist? Right. Living things exist in all the 3 spheres, that is hydrosphere, lithosphere, and atmosphere. And all these 3 things together constitute our biosphere. Yes, children? The geographical conditions at different places on our earth are very different. We find that living things exist in all these diverse conditions. Children, however a condition is, whether it is hot, whether it is cold, whether it is extreme, all the living things exist, right? When we live in a certain place, we adjust to the conditions there. Yes? Various types of living things have survived because of their ability to adjust to the conditions in the surroundings. Yes, children? Okay. Now we'll see about diversity in plants. Okay. How are plants different from each other? Children, we all know that there are a variety of plants in our nature, in our earth. Various types of plants are found in many places around us. Some plants like grass are short, while others are tall and they have a canopy. Some plants grow under the water, while some others float on water. Yes, children? We find that some plants grow even in the deserts. We all know that in the deserts, there is scarcity of water, right? But irrespective of that, some plants also grow in the deserts, right? Moreover, we find that there is a lot of variety in the same type of plant. For example, there are various varieties of rice and wheat. Yes, children? When you all go in shops, there are 5 to 6 varieties of rice as well as wheat. Yes? There are different kinds of roses. The color of the roses is different, right, children? Mangoes of different flavors. Yes? Have you all seen and eaten? Yes. Some plants grow even without stems, leaves, or roots. Okay.
these are very different from ordinary plants, right? So children, let us study this diversity among the plants, okay? Children, we all know that plants make their own food in sunlight. Yes, such plants are called as autotrophic plants. Okay, children? For example, hibiscus, pomegranate, periwinkle, etc. Some plants like funguses, Limanthus, dodder, use other plants for the food and are said to be heterotrophic plants. Okay, children? And some plants like the pitcher plant, they even consume insects, okay? So they are called as insectivorous plants. Fine, children. Once again, I'll repeat. There are three kinds of plants. First is autotrophic, right? Next is heterotrophic, and third is insectivorous plants. What are autotrophic plants, children? The plants which make their own food are called as autotrophic plants. And examples of that is hibiscus, pomegranate, periwinkle, etc. Some plants like funguses, loranthus, they use other plants for the food. They are called as heterotrophic plants, right, children? And some plants even consume insects, so they are called as insectivorous plants, right? Okay. Now, we'll see about structure of the plant. Okay, plant structure can generally be divided into two parts: the stem, which grows above the ground, and the root, which grows below the ground. Okay, children, the structure of the plant is mainly divided into two parts: the stem, which grows above the ground, and the root, which grows below the ground. The root, stem, and leaves are the main parts of the plants. This we all have learned since class 1. Yes? From time to time, plants bear flowers for reproduction. Flowers are transformed into fruits. Fruits have seeds. And seeds gives rise to new plants. Okay, children? Okay. Now we will see about the main structure of the plant. First, on the left hand side, top is the flower. Below that is the stem. On the right hand side is the leaf, and then is the fruit, right? And the root is there on the next page. Okay, children? So first we'll start from root. Okay, root means the base. Yes, children, the root of a plant is always under the ground. Okay, now we'll see in detail about the root. Roots hold the soil firmly and anchor the plant. Okay, The main functions of the root are to absorb and transport water and nutrients from the soil. The roots of the carrot and radish also store food. There are two types of roots, taproot and fibrous root. You all can see the picture. Yes, children. The example of taproot is hibiscus and banyan, whereas the example of fibrous roots is onion and grass. Okay, children. Now, we'll see about stem. The height, shape and size of a plant depends upon the stem. Okay? The stem carries out the functions of production, conduction and storage of food. In some plants, it has the function of reproduction and gives support to other parts of the plant. Children, what are the functions of stem? It has the functions of production, conduction and storage of food. Okay? And it also has a function of reproduction in some plants. And its main function is to give support to all parts of the plants. Yes, children? Then we'll see about leaf. Okay? The leaf of all the plants is flat. Yes. The leaf plays an important role in the production of food. How, children? Yes. The leaf has small openings called as stomata. Okay. And carbon dioxide is taken from the air with the help of leaves. With the help of these small openings. Okay. And so, it plays an important role in the production of the food. Leaves are mainly of two types, simple and compound leaves. You can see an example of a simple leaf and an example of a compound leaf. The example of a simple leaf is hibiscus leaf and the example of a compound leaf is rose. Okay. Now come towards the left. We'll see about the flower. Flower. This is the most attractive part of a plant. Yes, it is connected to the stem by a stalk which may be long or short. A flower has a typical color and shape. Yes, children, have you seen flowers? Yes, many a times, almost every day, right? The flower is an important means of reproduction. Children, what is the function of the flower? Reproduction. Okay? Then is the fruit. Fruits have different shapes. Fruits contain one or more seeds. The pods of the beans and the peas are actually fruits. Okay. Then, why there is a need for classification of plants, children? Up to now, information about lakhs of plants has been collected. While studying the diversity in the plants, they are classified for the sake of convenience, and hence there is a need for classification of plants. Okay, children? Next. The scientist Carolus Linnaeus made the first scientific classification of the plants, and initially, it was the method of classification that was used by all. Okay? And plants were classified according to where does it grow, nature of the stem, height, branches, leaves, flowers, nature of the fruit, and uses. Okay, children? Next. classification of plants. We can easily notice the differences in the shape and height of the plants in our surroundings, and it is easy to classify the plants on the basis of observation. Some plants are short, some plants are tall, their arrangement of the leaves is different, their fruits are different, their stems may vary, the roots are different, okay? So based on this, we can classify the plants, fine? Then, now we'll see about trees. Children, what are the similarities between a mango, banyan and tamarind tree? Tamarind means imli, okay? Banyan means vadasa jhad. Some plants grow tall. Their stem or trunk is hard and strong. They have branches at the same height above the ground. They bear flowers and fruits for many years. Such plants are called as trees. Trees are tall, big and perennial, means they live for many years. Children, did you all understand the similarity between a mango, banyan and tamarind tree? Yes. They have branches above the ground. They bear flowers and fruits for many years and they live for many years. These are the similarities between mango, banyan and tamarind tree. Children, we'll stop here for today. We'll continue with the lecture in the next period.